Hey Yas, and welcome back to another episode of me talking about Busho Shoujo Materialism. And man, this episode, very funny. I loved it. That's it. But what surprised me a little bit, well, not really. But man, Nomura was motivated to fight the next of the five sword girls. The green-haired girl going by the name Satori, I believe. She did something evil. Well, not really. A lot of people would be happy and would just go with the flow. But she took a picture of herself with Nomura naked in bed. And she was over him. Obviously, the picture was also edited with a ray of light because, well, we have to censor some very special parts of the body, right? Which is also a clue how Nomura was thinking to solve this problem. But this picture caused also trouble for him. After a good rest and that shit happened in the night, he was greeting the girls, having a good time, talking about their changes from the previous day, the different uniform from Rin, and the different perfume from Kikakujo? Kuja? Kajo? Man, I have to remember her name already. So, yeah, he complimented, well, pointed the differences out. They were happy because he didn't do it the day before, and they were unhappy about it. And also, most of the girls in school are kinda all over him right now because he was so cool when he was fighting the beer. But that green-haired girl, she is still crazy, and she wants to correct him. Or kill him, I don't really know. But this picture, two out of the three conquered girls from the Five Sword Council, two of them were tricked by the nature of this picture because they were angry and were very upset and wanted to beat him up. And the third girl we got last week with the beer, she was just like, oh yeah, that's it. It's obvious that this was a dirty play to kind of damage the relationship between the two girls and Nomura. And she didn't really like the method of Satori doing it, so she intends to help Nomura. His idea to solve this problem is to get the original data because the picture is edited and he remembered clearly that he didn't have a boner in that night, so something was fishy with his picture. So he's going to look for the original data and he wanted to go to the girl's dorm, but because he was there in the past, they increased the traps, and now he has to figure out how to get into that building. And there was one certain room called the torture room, where he would be put in if he went to the tournament if they catch him. So, what did he do? He let him. He was doing it so that they could catch him, and he was thrown into that room. And they caught him in a very awesome fashion because the third girl, I have to remember her name yet, she was yelling his name, the other came, and they were just standing there because it was his plan and she was going along with it. And man, they tortured him. Tying him up, hanging him head over on the ceiling and then beating him up. And there was a huge bucket of water below him. And the girls stopped. They saw something crazy, something shocking. It was the upper body of Nomura that was covered in scars, and the scars at the back were huge, and they were shocked. So they stopped, let him down, and left the room. Honestly, his aide was there, bring him some food, and they went to look for the data. They didn't find it, and when they ended up in the changing room of the bath, the Satori girl showed up with her sword. So obviously she was waiting for them to settle things. And now we have ended this episode, and I'm totally excited to see what will happen next. How will it be solved, and will the relationship be restored? Well, it will. But I don't know how yet. Will the girls walk in and see them fighting and then realizing, oh my god, they fell for Satori's trick? Or will he do something different? I don't know yet, because I haven't read the manga this far, but man, I like it. This episode was very funny. And the beer, oh god, so adorable. That beer, I want to hug it. But yeah, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye bye.